إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما قال الله تعالى في القرآن الحكيم والفرقان المجيد بعد أن أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يوم ترى المؤمنين والمؤمنات يسعى نورهم بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم بشراكم اليوم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ذلك هو الفوز العظيم صدق الله العظيم. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran in many places gives us advice on life. And it's the life of this dunya, and if we just follow these advices, we will find that we will have success in this dunya and success in the akhirah as well. One such place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does this, He paints a very vivid scene. He paints a very vivid scene of the Day of Judgment. And this is one of the most beautiful places that I love to go back and look at and read and contemplate on, because it's very powerful. There's no way you can read these ayat without having an image of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. And this place in the Quran is in Surah 57, Surah Al-Hadid, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about many things. But there's a passage in it where He fast forwards us to the Day of Judgment. He fast forwards us to the Day of Judgment, and He talks about a scene in the Day of Judgment between two groups of people. And in this, it's an amazing scene. So He starts out talking about the people that are successful. So naturally, those are the mu'mins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. And He's talking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and He says, on that day, يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, you will see, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will see the believing men and the believing women. يَسَعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. That they're carrying this light, this immense being. Not a light like a fluorescent light that we turn on and off, but nur. That we are shining, insha'Allah ta'ala. That there's light in front of us. Bayna aydihim. Bayna aydihim yani fis sudur. Something that's like in between our hearts. The light that's it's illuminating from our hearts. And it's shining. So He describes this scene. Wabi aymanihim. And from their right hand. And this Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma comments on this, and he says that that means the book of deeds, the book of good deeds, because we know that in Surah Haq Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the book of deeds, that the believers that get their a book in their right hand, right? Those are the successful ones. And then they will be saying to everyone, hey, come look at my book. Look at my book, right? And those who receive it in the other hand, in the left hand, they're just going to be like, oh, I wish I was just dust, right? So going back to that, The nur on the right hand is your book of deeds. So as much as you do in this life, charity, good works, prayer, all of these things that you do, they go in your book of deeds. So that will actually be a light for you on the day of judgment. بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ بُشْرَاكُمُ الْيَوْمَ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. He tells the Prophet ﷺ to congratulate those people. Congratulate them and give them glad tidings of a place that is unbelievable, unimaginable. You cannot fathom it. It's impossible for you to actually think of it in this world. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries to describe it for us in terms that we would understand. Things that we would be attracted to in this dunya. Jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar. Right? Especially in those times, we know that when the Quran was being revealed in the desert of Mecca, having gardens was like just owning palaces here, right? Gardens was the thing. If you had gardens, you were affluent, you were rich, you had no worries at all. And not only that, they were in the desert. So water was very scarce, right? بُشْرَاكُمْ الْيَوْمَ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Not nahr anhar, where rivers are flowing. Not one river, not a little pond, but rivers. So you can imagine the desert Arab thinking about this, right? They're living in a time where they have barely access to, there were times where they actually didn't have access to water, where some of the more affluent Sahaba, like Uthman radiallahu anhu, would go buy an entire well and say, this is for the believers, because it was so scarce, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala painting that picture for them, you can see that it's very attractive, right? And he's describing who? Al-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat. He's describing the believing men and the believing women. Khalidina fiha. Somewhere that you will be in forever. There is no leaving it. You will be with your gardens. You will be with your rivers. You will be with everything that you love forever. And he finished the ayah. Thalika huwa al-fawzul azim. Now that. You know, like, after you describe all of that, you're just like, isn't that what you want? That is really what success is, right? That is really what success is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now got the believers all happy with this ayah. And in the very next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أُنْذُرُونَا نَقْتَبِسْ مِنْ نُورِكُمْ قِيلَ ارْجِعُوا وَرَاءَكُمْ فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٍ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. Powerful ayah. Very powerful ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, after describing the believing men and the believing women, he goes to the hypocrites. He goes to the hypocrites. And he says, يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ. So the believing men and the believing women are all together. Now, I want you guys to imagine this. You're standing in a room full of people. It's dark. It's dark. There's no light. There's nothing. And there's light emanating from people, right? And you yourself, you're looking at that light and you're just like, I don't have the light. I see the light and I want that light. But you don't have it with you. So what would you do? You would try to get close to someone who has the light. Or you would ask them for a piece of the light. Can I borrow some of that fire that you have? Because I don't have, you know, how we light each other's candles when it's dark. Like when where I'm from, when the lights go out, you know, one person lights a candle and we all come and get, put our candles in that fire to light it. It doesn't take anything away from the candle that's already lit, does it? No. But it lights the other fire and it can light 100 of those. No problem. Right? So these people thinking that, just give me a little bit. So they say, المنافقون والمنافقات للذين آمنوا. They say to the believing men and the believing women, those who believed, right? انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. Please give us a little bit of that flame, a little bit of that light that you have. We want some of that. We don't have our own. Please. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from uttering these words on that day. So they say, please give us some of this light that you have, some of this light that you own. انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. And then it would be said to them, it says, قيلا, which is mabni majhul, meaning that it is said to them. It is not very. It's not a direct saying. Someone's like someone said this to them. No, it is qila. It is said to them. Now the scholars differ who says it to them. Ibn Kathir, rahimullah, he said that it is actually the believing men and the believing women who say it. And other scholars like Ad-Dahhaq, they say that it is actually not the people, but it is the angels or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying it to them. But it's not clear. But it is said to them, qila, irji'u. It is said to them, go back. No, you can't have any of my light. You can't have any of this. This is for mine. And I said earlier, it does not distinguish, it does not take anything away from the light that you already have. But on that day, everyone is responsible for their own selves. Everyone is responsible for their own light. You cannot borrow anyone's good deeds. You cannot do anything for anyone. أَلَّا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. I cannot help you, you cannot help me. We must help each other in this life, in this world of the dunya, where we can actually influence each other. This is where we help each other. So it is said to them, قِيلَ رُجِعُوا وَرَاءَكُمْ فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا. Go back to that place where the light was, and you'll find the light. It's sarcasm, right? قِيلَ رُجِعُوا, go back. You want, and it's actually in the commentary of this, it's very beautiful, that it's in the meaning of, go back to the world of the dunya, irji'u, go back to the world of the dunya that we already left, knowing that you can't go back there. Go back to there and try to find your own light, right? Because in that world, you didn't try to get the light. So why don't you go back there and try to get it? It's like an extra, it's like rubbing salt on a wound, right? So when the munafiq, they're so desperate that they actually turn back to go back and get some light. قِيلَ رَجِعُوا وَرَاءَكُمْ فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ. When they turn back and try to go get light, خلاص. From out of nowhere, boom, a door or a big wall just drops. فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورِ اللَّهُ بَابٍ. A big wall drops that separates now who? The believers from the hypocrites. SubhanAllah. Once they go back and try to get a light, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly distinguishes who were the believing men and women and who were the munafiqs. Bisuri lahu bab. And then what's interesting is this door, this wall has a door, right? And you see a door, naturally you will be like, oh, I can get out of whatever thing I'm in. But no, it's extra. The torment already started. They haven't even gotten into the hellfire. The torment has already started. This is psychological torture. You put a door there, they think that they have a chance now to get on the other side with the believing men and the believing women. But no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is a door. بِسُورِ اللَّهُ بَابٍ لَكِنْ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. That enclosed in that wall on the other side is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ay al-jannah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Udkhulu al-jannah, antum wa azwajukum, right? This is al-jannah on one side. And on the other side, subhanallah, the adab, hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws a clear line in between the hypocrites and the believing men and the believing women. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله كفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. My brothers and sisters, everything I've told you right now has been leading up to the actual fruit of this khutbah, the actual fruit of this passage. Because I told you in the beginning of the khutbah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us advice many places in the Quran. And if we follow these advices that He gives us, we will be okay. We don't have to look anywhere else. But we have to what? Go back to the Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now continues. Now you can imagine the scene, right? So everyone is listening, paying very close attention. What happens next? What happens next? So the hypocrites now call out, yunadunahum. They call out to who? Hey, guys, right? Because now there's a wall. So you scream a little bit. You nadu, they call out to the believing men and the believing women. You nadu nahum, alam nakum ma'akum. Allah. This is very, subhanAllah, this is just, subhanAllah. Were we not with you? Brothers and sisters, pay very close attention. Were we not with you? Were we not your buddies? Were we not your friends? Were we not your confidants? Were we not your well-wishers? Etc., etc. Were we not with you in the world of this dunya? Alam nakum ma'akum. Right? They call out to people. We were with you guys. Were we not your friends? Qalu bala. Walakinnakum fatantum anfusakum. And that's the first thing. The believing men and women will say, yes, you were with us. Of course you were with us. Bala yani, taban, you were with us. There's no arguing that. Walakinnakum, but you all did what? What was the first thing you did? Fatantum anfusakum. You went out of your way to put yourself in fitna. You went out of your way. It did not come find you. You drove 2 hours to it. Huh? You drove 2 hours to it. You picked up that phone and did that thing. You did that business. You went seeking out that business thing you know you shouldn't have been seeking out. And so on and so forth. You sought it out. It did not come to you. Fatantum anfusakum. You put yourself in the way of fitna. My dear brothers and sisters. My dear brothers and sisters, let's be careful of putting ourselves in a way of fitna when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing what? Putting fitna far away from us. A lot of times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us so much. He makes it so hard for us to commit haram, commit wrong, do bad things. But yet, what do? We work hard to try to get to that fitna. We work hard to try to get to that wrongdoing. For what? Momentary pleasure, momentary happiness, momentary. Al-hayat al-dunya khayrun wa abqa. The world of the hereafter is so much better. And it's everlasting. Khalidina fiha, he said. At the beginning, when I said the yawma tara al-mu'mineen, the end of that ayah, khalidina fiha, there is no escape, there is no leaving it. Not only will you not have a desire to leave it, but you won't leave it. Don't worry. And it just keeps getting better and better and better, second by second by second. This is al-jannah. But what do? We settle for this momentary happiness of this dunya. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ فَتَنْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ is interesting. The scholars say a few things. The strongest opinion is that وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ means basically we're looking forward to our destruction. Yani, you were looking forward for this thing, this matter, this Islam thing to actually be wrong. Right? You were actually just like, yeah, okay. It's like, we'll just wait on it. It's coming. You were actually, this Islam thing, yeah. But you were looking forward to it. You were like, I cannot wait until you're proven wrong. I cannot wait until you're proven wrong. Allahu Akbar. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ وَارْتَبْتُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. وَرْتَبْتُمْ means that basically you didn't think that the life of the akhirah was actually going to happen, right? You doubted this resurrection thing, but yeah, this is far-fetched. It's not actually coming. It's not actually coming. Imagine on the day of judgment, you are there and you're being told that this is why you are on the other side. Allah, this, and there's no going back. This is why you're on the other side, because waratabitum, you doubted the resurrection. You were iffy about it. You weren't too sure. You were 1 foot in, 1 foot out. Just in case, yani, right? Just in case, right, I'll go ahead and, you know, be Muslim, but your heart didn't have any iman in it. Something that's very, very, very serious. And we shouldn't think that we are safe from it. The person that thinks that they are safe from being a hypocrite is lost. Always check ourselves. We always have to make sure we check ourselves. It's very important. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ وَارْتَبْتُمْ وَغَرَّتْكُمُ الْأَمَانِي. وَغَرَّتْكُمُ الْأَمَانِي basically means that you had false hopes. that even if this thing, this matter was actually true, right? It's okay because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me for my sins. He's so merciful. I can do whatever I want. And at the end of the day, you know, Allah's, you know, God is love, as they say. So it's okay. I can do whatever I want and Allah will just forgive me. Right? You had this false delusion. You did nothing to deserve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. You doubted. You did everything in the book that you weren't supposed to do. And you went and tried to misguide other people. And then at the end of the day, when it came, you're like, oh no, I'll be fine though. Even if it's true. Right? Just like the sahib that had the garden in Surah Kahf, right? He was like, you know, even if that thing is true, Allah loves me so much, look what he's giving me. Of course I'm going to be okay, if it comes, right? So that's what, وَغَرَّتْكُمُ الْأَمَانِي حَتَّى جَاءَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. You lived like this your entire life until the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. Yani, you died. حَتَّى جَاءَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. Until the matter came to you. Yani, until the angel of death came to you, or the day of judgment happened. You lived your life like this. Just one foot in, one foot out. Weren't really focused. This Islam thing is like, yeah, I'm, you know what? I'm young. When I get a little bit older, I'll start practicing. You know, things like that. You were just not all the way there. Islam just was, it was a cultural thing, yani, less of more of a cultural thing and less of a thing that I actually love and, you know, cherish, right? Until the matter came to you. وَغَرَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغُرُورِ. Subhanallah. And this, my dear brothers and sisters, is the point of it all. This entire passage was leading to this last part. The deceiver deceived you. A shaitan deceived you. You let shaitan control you, you let shaitan deceive you, and shaitan will come on the day of judgment and he will say, I didn't do anything. Right? I didn't do anything. All I did was, he says, وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ فَأَخْلَفْتُكُمْ وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Very powerful ayah in Surah Ibrahim. That another conversation between shaitan and the people. They're coming to him like, you, what did you do? Shaitan is like, what are you talking about? I had no power. وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ. I had no power to do anything to you except that I said, hey, Hassan, come, let's go here. Hey, Hassan, look at this. Hey, Hassan, do this. Hey, Hassan, say this. That's all. That's the only power I had. You were the one that, you know, came when I just whispered to you. I didn't even say it loudly. Yani, I whispered it. And you came. So what did he say? فَلَا تَلُومُونِي. So do not blame me today. لُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourselves. So let's not let shaitan deceive us, my dear brothers and sisters. Things might look attractive. Things might look good. The world of this dunya is put here. It's a plaything, right? المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا والباقيات الصالحات خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير أملا. The world of this dunya is just a plaything. So let's not let the deceiver, who is shaitan, deceive us from what is actually better, which is the world of the akhirah, which is everlasting, and we get whatever we want there. No limits at all. We're here 60, 70, maybe 80 years, if we're lucky, right? But we're there for eternity. And it's hard for us to imagine what eternity is, but just think about that. Eternity, it doesn't end. And every day is better than the last. Every second is better than the previous. Allahu Akbar, what else do we want? What else do we want? So let's not let shaitan deceive us, my dear brothers and sisters. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيذكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة